Flyboy.
This is a rebellion, isn't it?
I call it aggressive negotiations.
The garbage will do!
Hi, and welcome to the Trash Compactor podcast. This is a new type of episode where we're going to be talking about different ships in the Star Wars universe and basically just talking through how these ships are possible, or not possible, but, you know, what makes them great. So this is the shipping yard. So I'm MC.
I'm Sarah.
So today we're going to be talking about a ship that is near and dear to our hearts from Star Wars Rebels. We're going to be talking about Zeb and Callus. How did this ship really start?
It started angrily.
Yes.
No, it did. I mean, even before we know what Callus did to Zeb's people, Callus was after the Ghost Crew.
Yes.
He wanted them captured, dead, out of the picture. It was just a very ugly relationship.
It was, yeah. It's
a very standard rebellion-imperial relationship.
Yeah.
But it was not good.
And then we find out that it was absolutely a personal hatred.
Right. Callus destroyed Zeb's people.
Yeah.
And was proud of it.
It's really hard to ship after genocide is involved.
Yes.
Yet, there is this ship. By the end of the show, they're married. Like, they're
all but married, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, like, we don't know what the status of their relationship is, but Zeb brought Callus home to the family.
And I think it's even more than that. I love that we're just skipping to the end.
Well, I mean, we started at the beginning, and then we went to
skip
the
to
end.
The end, and then fill in the middle.
Yeah.
So, for me, it's even more than Zeb bringing him home to meet the family. Because up till that point, Callus truly thought that there were no more Lasat. He thought he had killed them all and that Zeb was the last. I think even having watched Callus change through the show and go from Imperial to almost a rebel to Fulcrum to, like, hardcore rebellion... Mm-hmm. He still had in the back of his mind that he committed genocide.
Yeah.
To the people of someone that he is now working with every day.
Yeah.
And then Zeb got to take him home and go, you didn't.
Yeah, he gave him some absolution.
Yeah, he gave him absolution. He gave him forgiveness. He gave him peace.
Yeah.
And that is the most beautiful thing to me.
And I think he also gave him somewhere where he could belong, because, I mean, while he was with the Rebellion, there was always that him being a former Imperial. But I think just from, like, that silent shot that we saw, that Callus was getting a family with Zeb's people. Because we don't know if they were going for a visit. They might have been going there to live.
They might. And Callus, do you remember that Zeb had his hand over Callus's eyes? Like,
yeah.
I'm not telling you where I'm taking you. It's a surprise.
Yeah.
And, as much as I love everything about Rebels, that moment just made it for me.
So, I think the ship really kind of started in the episode The Honorable Ones, where they're together.
Where they're stuck together. They're trapped on a planet together. Trying not to freeze to death and get eaten by monster things.
Yeah. I mean, that's such, like, that's a fanfic trope, probably, right there.
Yeah, it is. Where one is injured, and neither can get out without the other, and they're forced to rely on each other to survive. You're right, that is the biggest fanfic trope, and I love it.
Yeah, I think the only thing missing was we only have one blanket, and we both need to get under it.
Yeah, but they had that one little heater source.
Yeah.
So it was kind of the same thing. It's like, let's cuddle together to not freeze.
Fair. But yeah, no, that's where it really started. That's when people, like, started to show interest in it.
And it didn't feel forced. Looking back at it, it should have.
Yeah.
This whole relationship changed over the course of 21 minutes.
Yeah.
It felt so natural. And maybe it felt natural because it wasn't forced at us at the end.
Yeah.
It was just Zeb went home to the ghost, who welcomed him back with open arms. Mm-hmm. And Callus went back to the Imperials, who didn't even notice that he was hurt.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just Callus's little bit of sadness.
Yeah. And then, of course, we don't find out about him being Fulcrum, like him taking over the role of Fulcrum until much later. Like, well, because, I mean, it doesn't happen like right then, but like there is like this gradual change in his character. It's it's not like he immediately like, I'm going to come with you and join the rebels.
Right. And then Zeb's realization that he accidentally recruited him.
Yeah. Oh.
And I wish I could remember the exact line because it was so adorable. But it was just, oh, I think that was my fault kind of moment. Yeah, Zeb accidentally adopted an Imperial.
As one does.
As one does, as one should.
Yes. Well, because the thing we do find out that most rebels are former Imperials because that's the government.
Yeah, exactly. And the ones that weren't Imperials were Separatists.
Yeah. So this is a great dynamic, but it is one that's not... There's a fair number of fics, but probably not as many as there could be. Why do you think that it's not as... Why it's not a juggernaut? Why is it a bit more of a sleeper?
I tend to find that juggernaut pairings don't tend to include aliens.
Fair, fair.
And that's a huge breaking point right there. Maybe it's that people aren't comfortable writing Zeb. Because everyone loves Callus.
Yeah.
I want to say everyone loves Zeb, but I'm not involved enough in Rebels specifically. Yeah. Rebels fandom specifically to know that. But yeah, I think writing a character that doesn't actually have a ton of lines.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of Zeb's characterization is physical.
Yeah.
And that is a hard thing to write.
And also, yeah, I think you're right on the whole alien thing. Because, I mean, it's not like he's a Twi'lek where he's just... he's not a bumpy foreheaded alien. He is an alien. Like, every bit of him is different. So I think there might be some discomfort there. I think there needs to be more. Because I love them so, so much. I mean, not only is the relationship beautiful, but it adds so much to their characters. Because it is this lovely redemption for Callus, and it shows an acceptance for Zeb.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they come to peace with each other.
Yeah.
And that is really a beautiful experience. I don't think we get to see it enough in Star Wars. So much of redemption in Star Wars involves dying.
Yeah.
It's kind of nice to see a future.
Yeah. So, not that we need any canonical word of God or anything, but apparently Dave Filoni totes okay with people shipping Callus and Zeb.
Yeah, didn't he say that it was perfectly okay to see what you want to see with that one?
Exactly.
That he specifically didn't make it specific.
Yes.
Which I think is the best way to do it.
Oh yeah, that is a great way to do things. Like, putting a button on things can sometimes ruin what people are doing. But leaving it nice and open-ended, you're giving a gift to the fans, where it's like, write what you want to write. Imagine what you want to imagine. And certainly with Zeb and Callus, they're fucking married.
And if they're not, they will be soon.
Yes. Yeah. Hera's a captain. She can officiate.
It's an alien race. Who knows what their marriage... what's the word I'm looking for?
Marriage laws? Their customs?
Customs! That's the word. Customs. Who knows what their marriage customs are? Maybe their custom is bring them home and you're married? Maybe it's, you know, tie them to a tree and swing them in a circle 8 times. Who knows?
I kind of want that to be it.
I can see that being the Lasat tradition, actually.
Now I might have to write that.
Sorry. Oops. That's... Not sorry.
Yeah. By the way, listeners, this is the perfect example of how Sarah encourages me to write shit, where we will talk about things, and then I will be like, fuck, I've got to write that now.
Imagine me sitting here with a shit-eating grin on my face.
I can see it. I can see it in my head. Like, anything else we want to say about Zeb and Callus?
I think that's it. I'm sure there are other things we could say, but we're trying to keep these short. So, yes.
And if any of our listeners have any ships they would like us to talk about, please, you know, shoot us a message on Twitter at SW Trash Podcast or at our individual Twitters. I'm at MC Frodis. That's EMCEEFRODIS.
And I'm at Murnell, MIRNELL.
And you can also go to thetrashcompactorpodcast.com or find us on Facebook, Tumblr, YouTube, everything. And we're the Trash Compactor Podcast. So until next time, ships away. Yeah.